This is gonna drive me nuts.
Come on, Dust.
I just completely changed my tech setup. Gone is my M3 Max MacBook Pro, my M4 Pro Mac Mini, my M4 iPad Pro, and my OWC Thunderbolt 4 dock. Let me show you why I made the switch and how I'm using these now. Hello, welcome to my channel. Today is going to be a little different. I'm going to be talking about the tools I'm using on this desk to get all of this YouTube stuff and my regular design job done. So let me start with what I was running before and why I made the switch. To be honest, this started in the weirdest of ways. I have a black lab. He's a wonderful dog, but he suffers from a little bit of anxiety. He gets very afraid in the afternoons and he likes to hide under my desk. The problem was that I had all these wires hanging out behind my desk. They were all going to the floor to a power strip on the floor. I was afraid that he was gonna pull something off. So I decided to fix the problem and mount the power strips up underneath my desk, cable tie all the wires, you know, do everything to really clean up the cables so that I had one cable going from my desk to the wall and less of a threat of him pulling it out. So during this project, I'm under the desk, I'm drilling holes, I'm mounting the power strips, I'm putting sticky tape on power bricks. I'm doing all this work. I'm putting everything on my desk. And it occurs to me while I'm doing this that I've really created quite a problem for myself. I think it happens to many of us. It happened over time. I didn't buy all of those things at the same time. Each thing I bought was introduced into my workflow, and then I was trying to solve problems with the other things, and I guess I just let it get out of control. Before I started this YouTube channel, I had upgraded from a 2017 MacBook Pro to a M1 iMac, which was glorious. The switch from Intel to M was the biggest thing that has happened to me in computing that I can ever remember. I can't remember anything being that significant. But while I had that iMac was when I decided to start my YouTube channel. And I discovered pretty quickly that video work does require a little bit more muscle. So that's what led me to getting the M3 Max MacBook Pro. And I got that pretty close to when it was released, which I believe was late 2023. I loved the performance of it. It was great. And the reason I went with the 14-inch model is because, in my opinion, the 16-inch does not afford you enough screen real estate to justify the price increase and the weight that you have to carry around. The 16-inch laptop is just as cramped as the 14-inch. I feel like I am cramped on a laptop. I never feel like there's enough space for me to really do my job. So I got the 14-inch because it's much more portable to me. I knew I was going to want to get a better display than the laptop when I did work at home. And so I got the studio display. Soon after that, I start to realize that my 1 terabyte hard drive in my M3 Max is not going to be sufficient to house all of my videos. And this leads me to getting a NAS server. Doing that over Wi-Fi is miserable. So what I wanted to do was connect via Ethernet because that's a much faster connection. All of that sort of led me to looking for a Thunderbolt dock that didn't just have a 10 gigabit Ethernet, but also had some USB-C ports, and it would be great if it could do CF Express Type-B. And lo and behold, I found one.
Today I got this OWC Thunderbolt Pro dock. It is the one with the CF Express Type-B card reader in it. Almost regret that I didn't do this sooner. 10 gigabit Ethernet hardwired, so I'm connected to my NAS server directly instead of Wi-Fi.
The OWC Thunderbolt dock was the perfect dock. It was Thunderbolt 4, it had CF Express Type-B, it had SD card slot, and then it had 10 gigabit Ethernet as well as the ports that I needed. And with this setup, there was some problems that started to occur. One of those was, I feel like every single time I tried to unplug my laptop from that setup, Mac OS would complain to me. It would say that one of my drives just couldn't be ejected and I had the option to force eject it. I never want to choose that option if I can avoid it. What I was discovering was it was becoming a pain. The only way that I could figure out to stop getting that error message was to just power down the computer. I would power down the computer, unplug everything, take it wherever I was going, and then power it back up. What ended up happening was I didn't use it that way. I just left my computer plugged in. Leaving your laptop plugged in all the time, what's the point of having a laptop? Something else that occurred was even when I did unplug and I'd take it out and use it as a laptop somewhere, my whole like creative life, everything that I was working on that's now not plugged into anything, all that stuff was just sitting there dormant until I plugged my computer back into it. So it was right around this time that Apple released the new Mac Minis, and I thought, this is perfect. I'll get myself a Mac Mini, an M4 Pro Mac Mini. I'll pay for that upgrade, and I'll have it on my desk, and I'll have everything plugged into it, and I could do most of my work at my desk while keeping my laptop a laptop. And then when I need the real power, when I need to get into Resolve and do one of these videos in Resolve, I'll just unplug the Mac from the studio display and plug it into my laptop and use the power of the M3 Max chip. Now, that's not what happened at all. Not even close. The convenience of having a Mac at my desk and not having to worry about my laptop was just too great. And even though the M4 Pro Mini is a very capable machine and can do almost everything I needed it to do, it still did choke a bit on Resolve. It was this desk project where I was, you know, plugging all that stuff in that I started to realize that I had everything backwards. Where I needed the power was on my desk. Where I needed practically no power at all was when I'm portable, when I'm out and about. I really don't need to do this kind of video if I'm on vacation. I decided that because I had it backwards and because I knew that I did most of my work in this office, that I wanted to really look at the Mac Studio. It was not a computer that I had considered before. I figured if you were going to get that much power, you might as well get a laptop. But I just don't use my laptop that way anymore. It's so different than it was pre-pandemic, where I had to have a laptop. Having a laptop was essential for my consulting business. Like, you had to have a laptop to go to people's offices. Since the pandemic, I do everything remote. I do all of my video calls right here in this desk. So what do I have today? I decided to get the M4 Max Mac Studio, and I did upgrade it slightly. I went from the 14-core, 32-core CPU and GPU to the 16-core and 40-core. And then I upgraded the RAM from 48 gigs to 64 gigs, and I got 1 terabyte of internal space. I went for the M5 iPad Pro, the 11-inch model again. I did briefly have the 13-inch model because I was thinking, well, since I'm getting rid of my laptop, I might actually want that extra screen real estate. And just like with the 16-inch and the 14-inch, I did not feel that the 13-inch provided enough value over the 11-inch to justify the cost increase and the weight increase. Take your iPad off the keyboard and use it as a tablet. And as soon as you start using it as a tablet, you'll see what I mean about the 13-inch model. It's simply not worth the weight. I quickly went back to the Apple store, traded it in. And the reason I wanted to upgrade from the M4 to the M5 is not because I was trying to get the latest and greatest. It was because with the M4, because I had my laptop, I got it really basic. I got it with 512 gigs of storage, no nano texture glass. It didn't have the upgraded RAM because I was on the lower storage. So this time I decided to get a 1 terabyte model, nano texture glass with the extra RAM. And the reason I wanted to do that is this is going to be my portable machine now. This is the machine that I need when I'm out and about. When I want to go do something portable, I'm going to need to use my iPad. What I've done really is I've just simplified everything. I think of my workflow in two modes now. I have my thinking mode and I have my doing mode. My thinking mode is my iPad. I love to use the Apple Pencil and the iPad Pro. Another thing I like to do with it, sometimes I'll encounter something that's just too difficult to use on my phone, so then I can switch over to iPad mode where I have more screen real estate and I can get that thing done. Now, if it's something that's being obstinate, like a website that just won't load on mobile, they'll do that to the iPad as well. Sometimes you go to a website that doesn't work on the iPhone or on the iPad. And in those moments, I need to get real Safari. And so for things like that, I have this app called Screens. It is a way for me to connect to my studio at home. I just need to get on Safari real quick and do something. So I'll open up Screens, log in my machine, and I can get on Safari and use Safari. It's actually really great. If I'm out and a client pings me and asks me if I can make a small change to a Figma file that I'm working on for them, I'll jump onto screens, make my edit on my studio in my office, and submit that to the client. And I, you know, for small changes like that, it's usable. I would never want to design anything full stack using screens. That would be a miserable experience. I really like that I have that separation of duties now. My iPad is this place where I go when I really want to think things through. When I get all that thinking done, when I get all my planning done, when everything is like where I want it to be and how, you know, my script is going and all of that is where I want it to be, I come and I sit at my studio and I get my work done. And that's really how this works. I'm very happy that I went this direction with it. Not having a MacBook Pro is a little weird. I had the iMac and that worked out because I had a work supplied MacBook Pro. And it's really interesting that I don't have a laptop at this point. I have a iPad with the Magic Keyboard. I've got my Apple Pencil. I'm editing photos in Lightroom. I just love editing photos on an iPad. I think it's wonderful. The nano texture glass doesn't bother me at all. I know that you get a little more contrast, a little more saturation without it, but it's so much better having a screen that doesn't reflect all the lights. Like if you're in a coffee shop or if you're in a library, they usually have bright overhead lights. It's so great having a screen that just is unaffected by that light. That's my new setup. My Thunderbolt dock was no longer necessary. I have all the I/O I need on the studio. I have a external SSD housing that sits right under the studio, and inside it are two bays for SSD drives. I have 2 4-terabyte drives in there, making a single 8-terabyte RAID, and that is as fast as my internal 1-terabyte drive is. It's incredibly fast. I can't believe it. That's my whole upgrade. I've never done one of these before, and I got to give a mad shout out to all the tech reviewers who do this kind of video, this desk setup stuff, because it is a lot harder than it looks. And I'm actually really surprised how hard it was for me to make this video. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed it. If you did enjoy it, please remember to give it a thumbs up. That definitely helps the channel. And if you liked it, please consider subscribing. I don't always do tech videos about my desk setup, but you know, I do like to talk about the technology I use from time to time. And as always, I thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one. Thank you. Bye.